that I am going to be asked. It means that there is something called responsibility and retribution. You see, if I entrust you with a job, if I entrust you with a purpose, now you have a purpose. Your mom tells you, go to the store and buy some sugar. You have a purpose of why you're going to the store, correct? You've been entrusted with a purpose. So now you go to the store and you come back. What's going to happen? She's going to ask you. You are going to be asked. She's not going to tell you to go get sugar and then not ask for the sugar. She's not going to tell you to go do something, give you a purpose, entrust you with a purpose, and then not ask you, and then not hold you accountable. So she's going to ask you, where's the sugar? Did you go and get the sugar? And what are you going to say? Actually, I got really distracted on the way there. Saw this really nice car. You know, I started running after this car, taking pictures of the car. I forgot, sorry. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to ask us about our purpose. And if all of this was not created without a purpose, then that means that you and I will be asked. Don't think that going through your life heedlessly, going through your life and just caring about what's in fashion or what your friends are doing or what's on Facebook or what's in the movies or what's in the whatever's new in style, entertaining yourself, video games, whatever, having a lot of status, having a lot of fame and money. Don't think that if you live your life only caring about those things that you're not going to be asked. See, a person who stays up all night when they have a final exam, and if they stay up all night partying and they don't study, does that mean the exam is not going to happen? The exam's still going to happen. You and I are still going to die. You and I are still going to go to the Day of Judgment. You and I are still going to stand in front of Allah. That is a non-negotiable. That's not something that's going to be stopped or delayed. The only thing that's going to matter is whether or not you're prepared. And the fact that you stayed up all night wasting your time partying, wasting your time running after money or people or status, the fact that you wasted your life just worrying about those things does not mean that the final exam isn't coming. It's still gonna come, but we just end up failing. And so the end of this dua in Surah Al-Imran is فَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. After acknowledging that there is a purpose to everything, is the dua, so protect us from the punishment of hellfire. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم إنه غفور رحيم سبحانك الله وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.